Good morning, YouTubes. This is the replacement upper heater element for my Kenmore or GE SpeedCook oven. So this is the halogen element. This is your ceramic element. And I picked this up off of eBay. And like I said, it's used. This sits on top of the oven. This one's actually a lot cleaner than mine was, probably because mine had burned out and it wasn't heating it up. But anyway, what I wanted to do before I go to the significant effort of installing this is I was going to plug this into my bench supply, make sure that everything works. So there we go. I won't go up to full voltage because it'll zap the camera, but you can see the bulb definitely turns on. That's your 500 watt halogen. And I can show you that up here on the supply. 120 volts, you can see we're gonna hit 500 watts pretty easily. Okay, so I've switched on to the ceramic heater element. We can check that one out here. I won't run this very long because it'll get really hot. And I gotta actually put it back in today. But there we go, get up to 120 volts. And it looks like it's 600 watts, like it's supposed to be. So that looks good. Yeah, so the ceramic element doesn't really do much. It just gets hot inside. And then inside the oven, there's also a traditional heating element that kind of snakes over the top of this that's, I think, 1100 watts. And so I think the idea is they switch back and forth between this 1100 watts and then the heater element. So one thing I was thinking about with these halogen bulbs, they're very similar to the kind that you use in halogen floor lamps, the torchiere fixtures, and also used in automobile headlights. And one of the big warnings that goes along with these is do not touch the glass envelope or the quartz envelope of the bulb, because that will shorten the life, because your fingerprints will leave oils on the bulb surface. Those oils burn and turn black, like you can see on this ceramic element. You can see where I didn't clean off all the gunk on there. And you can imagine this bulb is sitting on top of the oven. There's an open screen below this, and there's nothing to prevent grease and stuff splattering off the food you're cooking, because this is essentially a broiler here. When you run your boiler in your regular oven, there's a lot of smoke that comes out, and that's because the grease and water and stuff popping off the top of your food as it cooks goes up and hits the hot element, and then it vaporizes. That's just like touching, you know, your finger all over that halogen bulb. So I was thinking I might try something different here. So they make these quartz crystal shields that go over the top of your halogen floor lamps for specific. I had some of these in my halogen floor lamp, although unfortunately I threw them all away when I converted them all to LEDs. But look at this. There's one, and there's two. I can put two of those, cover this bulb. That is like a perfect fit. This glass or quartz surface will now collect all the splatters. It should get hot enough to burn that stuff away and protect the bulb underneath. I am thinking I might try this on this bulb and see if I can extend the lifetime, because that's probably the cause of this bulb burning out, because it's in the direct line of fire, so to speak. If one fingerprint on a bulb like this can shorten its life, you can imagine putting this bulb over some hot sizzling food in your oven, and it's going to get splattered like crazy. And I'll show you a picture of my bulb when I get it torn apart, and it's just totally discolored, and that could probably be the reason why. I'll try this And then if that doesn't work, then I've got a new replacement bulb that I can put in. And I mean, the old bulb lasted probably 8 to 10 years. It's not like it's a high failure rate item, but it is a real pain to replace. So I'll show you what it looks like when I go to put it in here.